Hey guys, do you want to learn your ABCs? And how about a little bit of astronomy? Well, why not learn them both together?
A is for astronaut, a person who is trained to travel on a spacecraft. A is for asteroid, a small, rocky, non-planetary body orbiting the sun. And most of all, A is for astronomy, the study of all the celestial objects in our universe, and the theme behind our alphabet.
B is for black hole, an area in space where the matter from a dying star squeezes into an extremely tiny space, creating an immense gravitational force. The gravity in a black hole is so strong that nothing, not even light, can escape.
C is for comet, a cosmic snowball of frozen gases, rock, and dust that orbit the sun. When its orbit brings it close to the sun, it heats up and spews dust and gases into a giant glowing head. And the dust and gases form a tail that stretches away from the sun for millions of miles. There are approximately 3,743 comets known to astronomers. C is for crater, a circular depression in the surface of a planet, moon, or other body, usually formed from a meteor impact. C is for constellation, an area in the celestial sphere in which a group of visible stars forms a perceived outline or pattern, usually representing an animal, mythological person or creature, or an object. One of the most well-known constellations is the Big Dipper.
D is for dwarf planet, a smaller celestial body that orbits the sun, has enough mass to assume a nearly round shape, has not cleared the neighborhood around its orbit, and it's not a moon. E is for Earth, the third planet from the sun, and the one you call home.
F is for full moon, the lunar phase that occurs when your moon appears fully illuminated from Earth. The moon receives its illuminated effect from the light projected from our sun.
G is for galaxy, a system of stars, interstellar gas, dust, and dark matter bound together by gravitational force. Our galaxy is called the Milky Way, and astronomers estimate that the observable universe contains approximately 2 trillion. G is for gravity, the universal force of attraction acting between planets, stars, galaxies, and even light.
G is for gas giant, a large planet composed mostly of gases such as hydrogen and helium. We have 2 gas giants in our solar system, Jupiter and Saturn.
Yes, Venus just mentioned hydrogen and helium. That brings us to our next letter. H is for hydrogen, the most abundant element in the universe, with helium being the next. They combine to make up 99.9% of all matter.
I is for ice giant, a large planet composed mainly of elements heavier than hydrogen and helium, such as oxygen, carbon, nitrogen, and sulfur. We have 2 ice giants in the solar system, my bruh Uranus and myself.
J is for Jupiter, the largest planet in our solar system and fifth planet from the sun. I'm so big that you can fit 1,300 of your planet Earths inside of me. And I'm the only astronomy-themed letter that starts with J. K. K is for Kuiper Belt, a donut-shaped ring of icy objects around the sun, extending just beyond the orbit of Neptune. By studying it, scientists may be better able to understand how planets were formed. L. L is for Light Year, the unit of length that measures the distance that light travels in the time span of one of your Earth years. It is equivalent to about 9.46 trillion kilometers, or 5.88 trillion miles.
M. M is for Mercury, the smallest planet in the solar system, and the closest to the sun.
M is for Mars, the second smallest planet in the solar system, and fourth from our solar mass.
M is for Moon, a natural satellite of a planet our Earth has just won, while Saturn now has 82 known moons.
M is for Meteoroid. Meteor? Meteorite? So what's the difference? Well, when these small rocky objects are traveling through space, they're meteoroids. But when it enters a planet's atmosphere at a high speed and burns up, the fireballs, or shooting stars, are called meteors. If it survives the trip through the atmosphere and hits the ground, it's called a meteorite. Hope that clears it up for you.
N is for Neptune, the coldest and windiest planet in our solar system, and last from the sun. N is for Nebula, a giant cloud of dust and gas in the vacuum of space. Some nebulae come from the explosion of a dying star, such as a supernova, while others come from regions where new stars are beginning to form.
O. O is for orbit, a path of a body revolving around an attracting center of mass as a planet around the sun or a satellite around the planet. O is for Oort cloud, a hypothetical spherical distribution of icy bodies located in the far reaches of our solar system.
P. P is for Pluto, a dwarf planet in the Kuiper Belt. For 76 years, it was declared to be the ninth planet from the sun until 2006, when astronomers downgraded the status of Pluto to that of a dwarf planet because it did not meet the criteria.
And while we're on the letter P, P is for planets. So what is the difference between a dwarf planet like Pluto and the eight of us? Well, a planet is any relatively large natural body that revolves in an orbit around the sun. The object should be 1,000 kilometers across. It should be large enough to have been squeezed by its own gravity into a sphere, and it must have a mass insufficient for its core to have experienced even temporary nuclear fusion. Phew!
Q. Q is for Quasar, an extremely luminous galactic nucleus powered by a supermassive black hole with mass ranging from millions to tens of billions of times the mass of our sun. They're now known as young galaxies, located at vast distances from us and up to 1,000 times brighter than our Milky Way galaxy.
R is for radiation, an energy that comes from a source and travels through space at the speed of light. It has an electric and a magnetic field associated with it and wave-like properties. We also call them electromagnetic waves. Radiation could come in small amounts in everything from your microwave to your cell phone, or in massive, dangerous amounts such as from the sun.
S. S is for Saturn, the second largest planet and the sixth planet from the sun, and the one with all the beautiful rings. S is for Satellite, a moon, planet, or man-made machine that orbits a planet or a star.
S is for Solar System, a collection of planets and their moons in orbit around a star, together with smaller bodies in the form of asteroids, meteoroids, and comets. S is for star, an astronomical object consisting of a luminous spheroid of plasma held together by its own gravity, which leads us to the star in our own solar system, which also coincidentally starts with the letter S, the Sun.
S is for space station, a spacecraft capable of supporting a human crew in orbit for an extended period of time. The most well-known is the ISS, which stands for International Space Station.
T is for telescope, an optical instrument using lenses, curved mirrors, or a combination of both to observe distant objects. T is for terrestrial, as in terrestrial planets, a planet made up of rocks or metals with a hard surface. They consist of a molten heavy metal core, few moons, and features such as valleys, volcanoes, and craters. The terrestrial planets in our solar system are Mercury, Venus, Earth, and Mars.
U is for Uranus, not Uranus, and the third largest planet and the seventh from the Sun. U is for universe, all of space and time and its contents, including planets, stars, galaxies, and all other forms of matter and energy. All of it makes up the universe.
V is for Venus, the third smallest planet and the seventh from the Sun. And also the hottest.
V is for vacuum, a space in which there is no matter or in which the pressure is so low that any particles in the space do not affect any processes being carried on there. The only known organism to survive the low pressure vacuum of space is the tardigrade.
W is for white dwarf, the final stage of a star. A dense core of it remains after it has exhausted all its nuclear fuel and shed its outer layers. A white dwarf is very dense. Its mass is comparable to that of the Sun, while its volume is comparable to that of the Earth.
X is for X-ray, a penetrating form of high-energy electromagnetic radiation of extremely short wavelength and high frequency. In space, X-rays come from objects that are extremely hot, such as pulsars, galactic supernovae remnants, and the accretion disk of black holes.
But here on Earth, medical technicians use X-ray imaging to take pictures of the inside of your body.
Why is the yellow dwarf a small massing red star? Our own Sun is actually a yellow dwarf.
And finally, Z. Z is for zodiac, an imaginary belt of the heavens within which are the apparent paths of the Sun, Moon, and principal planets. It contains 12 constellations, hence 12 divisions called the signs of the zodiac.
Hey guys, that's it for the ABCs of Astronomy. I hope you learned a lot from Elvio. Please leave the like and subscribe and see you next time. Bye bye.